Hello friends, welcome to Saurabh Sharma YouTube channel. Friends, in last video we had discussed about three-phase transformer. What is it and how it works? In that video we had quick preview of OLTC, that is on load tap changer. So in this video we will understand OLTC in more details about it working and construction. Friends, you have found right video if you are wanting to know about OLTC. I promise you till today you will not find any other video which explains all these details in very simplified manner. So please watch the video till the end with patience. And new viewers, please do subscribe our channel. So come to the topic. From name, it is clear that it helps in changing the taps of transformer during on-load condition. Now the question is, why it is necessary to change the position of taps in transformer? This is because when power or distribution transformers gets loaded, their terminals voltage get reduced due to internal voltage drop in the impedance of the winding. And similarly, when the load on the transformer is reduced, then its terminals voltage exceed the expected value. This variation of terminals voltage due to variation of load is known as voltage regulation. The variation of terminals voltage can be restricted near to expected value by changing tap position in the transformer winding. And this can be done without making the transformer off, by the help of a cylindrical device, that is on load tap changer, or in short it is called as OLTC. The device is generally but not necessarily installed inside the transformer tank along with the winding assembly, and it is always connected to high voltage winding. Friends, before going into its detail, let's have some fair understanding of voltage regulation. Suppose we have a distribution transformer at the load end, so it must be a step down transformer, and number of loads is connected to the secondary winding. Here, this represents the internal impedance of the secondary winding. When the transformer is on no load, that means all the connected loads are off. However, transformer is in working condition, means it is being energized from HV side. In this condition, the output voltage will exactly equal to the voltage which is being induced in the secondary winding. Because there is no current is flowing, therefore, whatever be the impedance of the secondary winding, no voltage will drop. Suppose that HV winding consists of 100 turns and the applied voltage is 100 volt. The voltage distributes itself uniformly across the HV winding and each turn will get 1 volt. As in case of transformers, the voltage of all the turns of all the winding associated with a common core must always be equal. Therefore, as a result, induced voltage in each turn of secondary winding must be equal to 1 volt. Now suppose if secondary winding consists of 10 turns, the total voltage of secondary winding will be equal to 10 volt. But when if load is connected, and now suppose 1 ampere current is flowing and 1 ohm be the internal impedance, then according to 1 ampere and 1 ohm, the voltage which is get dropped will be equal to 1 volt. So the output voltage will be equal to 9 volt. Whereas the voltage induced is 10 volt and we are getting 9 volt because 1 volt is getting lost in overcoming the internal friction of the winding. Similarly, when 2 ampere current is drawn, 2 volt will get lost and we will get 8 volt at the output. This decreased voltage, or we can say pressure, is most of the time is not sufficient for our connected loads and can severely affect their performance. So to overcome this drop in voltage, or we can say voltage regulation, tappings are used in the transformer winding. For that, a number of connections are taken out from in between turns at regular intervals. This is always done at high voltage winding because of two main reasons. Number one, HV winding is always wound outer side, therefore it is easy to access it. Number two, at the HV side, the winding current is comparatively low as compared to LV side, so it is easy to make and break the circuit without heavy sparking. As it is highly desirable that continuity of electrical supply must always be maintained, so for that the tap changing process is required to be done when transformer is on. The drop in the output voltage due to load current is compensated by reducing number of turns in the HV winding. This improves the per turn voltage of HV side and followed by increase in per turn voltage of LV side. This process is further continued up till the output voltage regains its previous strength. Although this process is not easy, the internal structure of OLTC is quite typical. Here, the high voltage winding is shown from which different tappings are brought out. This is the first tap, this is the second, the third and the fourth. The arm which rotates inside OLTC is made of two parts. The front part is the selector arm and the back part is known as bypass switch. Selector arm is made in two parts, the left part and the right part. Both the parts consist of reactor coil, which is simply an inductor, which opposes the sudden change in the current. The both left and right part is connected through a vacuum switch. When the tap position in the transformer is need to be changed, it need to follow a proper sequence. Otherwise, it may cause heavy sparking. Transformer winding and terminal could get burned. As here, the arm is connected on tap 1. When the output voltage of secondary winding gets reduced due to heavy load, the arm must be shifted from tap 1 to tap 2 because the active number of turns at HV must be reduced to increase the secondary voltage. To do so, the sequence followed is, first the front part, that is the selector arm, moves a bit so that the right part gets freed from the tap 1 as vacuum switch is already opened. And now there is no voltage on right part. Due to further movement, the right part gets in contact with tap 2, which is at slightly less voltage than tap 1. Now vacuum switch operates so that tap 1 and tap 2 gets in contact and the voltage of both the taps become equal. Due to this sudden closed circuit, a current gets circulated in the loop, which is limited by these reactor coils. Now the bypass switch can completely move on to right part and vacuum switch become open. This isolates the left part and therefore the tap 1. Due to this, these turns become out of loop and the applied voltage is now applicable to these turns only. Now selector switch can completely move on to tap 2. If there is further drop in the output voltage again, tap position has to be changed from tap 2 to tap 3. For that, the same sequence must be followed. Let's look it with a quick animation. We can see all the turns after tap 3 get out from the loop. Similarly, to reduce number of turns further, same process is followed. And this way, we can opt minimum turn at HV side. When the load on the transformer is released, the output voltage could exceed from its rated value as it has minimum number of turns in this position. To avoid this situation, the reverse must be done and this follows the exact reverse sequence as we can see from this quick animation. But this is representing only one winding of HV side. As high rating transformers are of 3-phase type and consist 3 HV winding. Therefore, an OLTC has 3 such assemblies within it and all the arms are coupled through a common shaft. Now to understand the connection of OLTC, you have to go through another video which is again very important topic. Friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, please like and share. And I request to new viewers, please subscribe our channel so that you will get notification of our upcoming videos.